Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part three of equations and graphs of ellipses, and in this video, we go over the standard form of an ellipse that is not centered at the origin, and we do the following two problems. In ellipses part 1 and 2, we worked with ellipses centered at the origin, and we came up with a standard form here, x squared over a squared plus y squared over b squared equals 1. Now, if an ellipse is not centered at the origin, but instead is centered at HK, right, someplace else, then the equation written in standard form is x minus h squared over the a squared plus the y minus k squared over b squared equals 1. And in fact, this is the general form no matter what, because if it's centered at the origin, it just means h is 0 and y is 0, and it looks right back up here, the first equation shown. So this is similar to circles. Remember with circles, if you have a circle not centered at the origin, you had x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. Right, it's kind of similar. So how would we go ahead and graph an ellipse that has a different center than the origin? So here's a problem. Graph and state the vertices of the ellipse. Okay, now if this was just x squared over 9, the vertices are easy. It's just the x and y, the x-intercepts 3 and negative 3, and the y-intercepts 5 and negative 5. But everything's going to be off-center here. So the first thing for us to determine is what is the center of this ellipse? And I'm going to write that right here. What would the center of the ellipse be? So instead of x, I have x minus 2. Basically, you're saying what would make what's in the parentheses 0, or x minus 2 is 0. That would be 2, because it's x minus h. Okay, so h is 2. And for the y value, it's negative 1. So where is that? Okay, so here's a graph. 2, negative 1 is right here. Now here's the easy way to graph the ellipse once you find the center. What I like to do is like dot in the horizontal line going through that center and the vertical line going through that center. And I'm going to just kind of pretend that that's where the origin is. It's not the origin, right? That point. It's really the center of the ellipse. But here's what I mean. If this was just x squared over 9, remember, I know that 9 is 3 squared, I would go 3 to the right and 3 to the left to get my vertices. That's exactly what we do here, except we go 3 to the right and 3 to the left from where this center is. So I go 3 to the right is right here. And 3 to the left is right here. So what are those vertices? That's negative 1, negative 1. That's this vertex. And what's this vertex over here? This is 5, negative 1. So I'm going to write my vertices here. I have negative 1, negative 1, and I have 5, negative 1. So far, I have two vertices. If you want, you could plug in 5 for x and negative 1 for y and convince yourself this is true. Like, for instance, if you put in 5 for x in this original equation, you would get 3 squared over 9, which is 1, right? And if you put in negative 1 for y, this whole term cancels and you get a 0. So you get 1 equals 1. So this really is on that graph. Okay, now what about the other vertices in the y direction? This is really 5 squared. So from this center, I'm going to go up 5 and down 5. So I go up 5 and I go down 5. All right, what are those order pairs? That's 2, 4. Right, so that's one of them. And this is 2, negative 6. So we now have our center and we have our four vertices of the ellipse. And at this point, we're just going to go ahead and sketch what that ellipse looks like. It might not really be going through where I have it go through the y-axis or the x-axis because I am just sketching. If you want to know exactly where it goes through the x-axis, put in 0 for y and solve this. And if you want to know exactly where it goes to the y-axis, put in 0 for x and solve it, and you could get a more accurate picture. I'm just getting a rough estimate of what this picture looks like. All right, so we're just sketching the basic idea. All right, so there we have our ellipse. Now, this method makes it easy to find the vertices by just looking at the picture. Writing it out algebraically is a little bit more complicated, a little more critical thinking going on, but let's see if we could notice something here. Look at the center, 2, negative 1. All right, so here's the center, 2, negative 1. Notice that if the first thing I think I did was get my x coordinates, this negative 1, negative 1, and 5, negative 1. Notice when I wanted to move to the left and right, the y coordinate of the center stayed the same. Okay, so if I'm going left or right, the y coordinate stayed the same when I got my vertices. But what happened to the x coordinate? Well, notice this 3 here. I really went 3 to the right and 3 to the left. What did I do? I took my x coordinate and I subtracted 3. That's how I got this negative 1 for one of the vertices. And I took this x coordinate and I added 3 to get my other vertex. So instead of it being simple, you know, like a0 and negative a0, it's not quite as simple. But here's what I really did to get my vertices. So if I took my 2 and I look and see what number is associated with the x in the denominator, which is the 3, I add 3 and keep the x coordinate, and then I subtracted 3 and kept the x coordinate. Right? That's how I got 5, negative 1, and negative 1, negative 1. Now, how about for the y part here? What stays the same? Notice how the 2 is the x coordinate of the center. So that stayed the same, right? But my y value, what happened to my y value? I went up 5, so I added 5, and that's how I got up here at 4, right? So the y coordinate was negative 1, and I added the 5 this time, right? Because that's the number associated with the y squared here, 5. And then I subtracted 5. So if you had to write it out using a formula, it's a little more complicated. It looks something like that. It's easier, really, just to graph it and then look and see where it goes through those axes. But of course, we could write this out algebraically as well. So let's see what that would look like. So here it is in general, the equation of an ellipse centered at HK, written in standard form is, this is the form we already discussed, and the vertices, if you want to think about it algebraically, are written as I have right here. So here's one more problem. So why don't you put the video on pause and see if you could do this one on your own? All right. So what is the center of this one? Well, x is offset, it's negative 1, and the y, it's just y squared, so we've got 0. So negative 1, 0 is right here, right? So I'm going to just sort of dot in. You don't have to do this dotted line, but it might help you. Here would be the other one, it would be the same as the x-axis. So from negative 1, 0, in the x direction, I'm going to go 4 to the right and 4 to the left. In the y direction, since it's a 4, that's 2 squared, I'm going to go up 2 and down 2. And that's all we have to do to graph the ellipse. So what are the vertices? Well, I've got a negative 5, 0. And I have a 3, 0. Those are the ones on the horizontal axis. And then we have negative 1, 2. And we have negative 1, negative 2. And that's all there is to it. Now, if you wanted to use the formula without graphing it, you have to think kind of carefully here. You have to think, well, what if I wanted to get my vertices that way? So I know that the x-coordinate of the center is negative 1. And then how would I get my y-values? I would take what my y-value of my center is, which is 0, and I would go up 2 and down 2. So I go 0 plus 2, and then I go 0 minus 2. And that's, of course, the same as these two vertices right here, right? And how would I get the other ones? Well, I would say I'm going to keep my y-value the same, right? And then what would I do? My x-value of the center is negative 1, and since below here I've got 16, that's 4 squared, I'm going to add 4 to that, and then I'm going to subtract 4 from that negative 1. So let's say if I do negative 1 minus 4, that gives you negative 5. And then you do negative 1 plus 4, that'll give you 3. Notice I could do the vertices completely with using algebra, you know, just adding those numbers instead of graphing and looking at it. So you could do it either way. All right, so that's the general form of an ellipse right here. Sorry, this is the standard form, right, in general is what I meant to say. And we'll be working now with problems that aren't necessarily already in this nice form in the next videos. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.